In part 2 of our lesson on fundamental identities, you will learn how to solve for trig function values using only the identities. First, a quick algebra review of the square roots property. We've used this already during the semester, but I just want to remind you, when you have x squared equals a, and you take the square root of both sides, the square root of x squared is absolute value of x. The square root of a, of course, square root of a. Notice there's no plus or minus here. The square root of a is not plus or minus radical a. The square root of a, which a is a constant in this case, the square root of a is radical a. Where the plus and minus comes in is because the absolute value of x equaling radical a means that x could be plus or minus radical a. So to put some concrete numbers on this, say for example we had x squared equals 64, and we took the square root of x squared and we took the square root of 64. The square root of x squared is absolute value of x. The square root of 64 is 8. Notice that it is not plus or minus 8. We're talking about the principal square root of 64 is 8. Then, because we have absolute value, that means x could be plus or minus 8. Now, what applying the square roots property allows us to do is to go immediately from the first step to the last step. And if you want to do that, you just have to invoke the square roots property. So when you have an equation that looks like this, it's fine to go right to here. Just say that you're using the square roots property, and you can abbreviate it, as far as I'm concerned, with SRP for square roots property. So let's see how this comes into play in trigonometry. In this example, we're given that sine of theta is 2/3, and that theta is between pi over 2 and pi. The instructions say, using only the identities, find the other 5 trig function values of theta. So for this example, you're explicitly directed not to use the trig definitions. And we know the trig definitions involve x and y and r, drawing a picture and finding x, finding y, finding r. For this example, we're not going to do that. We're going to use only the identities. So all those identities you just gathered up on the first page of your notes here. We know that we've got sine of theta is equal to 2/3. We are looking for an identity that involves sine of theta and another trig function, for example, cosine of theta. Using one of the Pythagorean identities, we can say that cosine squared of theta is equal to 1 minus the sine squared of theta, which means cosine of theta is going to be plus or minus the square root of 1 minus sine squared of theta. And this step is by the square roots property. So now we have plus or minus the square root of 1 minus 2/3 squared, which is plus or minus the square root. Well, let's see. If we square this out, we see we're going to be subtracting 4/9. So I'm going to take 1 and write it as 9 over 9. This becomes plus or minus the square root of 5 over 9, which is plus or minus radical 5 over 3. Now let's talk about whether this is going to be positive or negative. We were given that theta is between pi over 2 and pi, which means that it is in quadrant 2. So because we are in quadrant 2, we know that cosine is negative. So we're going to choose the negative sign here and say that cosine of theta is equal to negative radical 5 over 3. Once you have sine and cosine, you can find everybody. So now tangent of theta is going to equal sine of theta divided by cosine of theta. An important side note here is you must show first the trig identity that you're using and then substitute in the values. You cannot just start writing values here. You must show the trig identity first and then plug in the numbers. So we know sine of theta is 2/3, and we just found out that cosine of theta is negative radical 5 over 3. In this case, the 3's in the denominator are going to cancel. So we have negative 2 over rad 5, and now we're going to rationalize rad 5 over rad 5. So we get that tangent of theta is negative 2 radical 5 over 5. Cosecant of theta is equal to 1 over the sine of theta. Again, just a reminder, show that identity first, then plug in the number. So we get 1 divided by 2/3, which is 3/2. Secant of theta is going to be 1 over the cosine of theta, which is 1 divided by negative rad 5 over 3, which becomes negative 3 over radical 5. And we will rationalize this guy, multiply by rad 5 over itself, and we get negative 3 radical 5 divided by 5. And finally, cotangent theta. You have two choices here. You could say cosine theta over sine theta, or you can say 1 over the tangent of theta. Either one works. So maybe we'll do 1 over the tangent of theta. We will get 1 divided by negative 2 radical 5 over 5, which is negative 5 divided by 2 radical 5. Rationalize the function, rad 5 over rad 5. We get negative 5 radical 5 over 10, which reduces to negative radical 5 over 2. So by using the value of the sine of theta and the fact that we were in quadrant 2, we were able to find the other five trig function values of theta by using only the identities. So notice there's no x, no y, and no r. For this example, we did not want to use the trig definitions. We were practicing using only the identities.